Amy is planning to throw a party and is using her favorite punch recipe. The recipe calls for 1 liter of lemon lime soda for every 3 liters of juice. So notice how if Amy uses exactly 1 liter of lemon lime soda and 3 liters of juice, this would create 1 plus 3, which equals 4 liters of punch. For part A, we're asked to find the ratio of the amount of soda to the amount of juice. When writing a ratio, it's important to pay close attention to the order of the ratio. This is a ratio of the amount of soda to the amount of juice. And we can write a ratio 3 ways, using a fraction bar, using the word to, or using a colon. So looking back at the given information, the ratio of soda to juice is 1 to 3. We're not required to write the ratio all 3 ways. All these ratios mean the same thing. For part B, we're asked to find the ratio of the amount of soda to the amount of punch. So again, here we're looking for the ratio of amount of soda to the amount of punch. So looking back at the given information, notice how if Amy uses 1 liter of lemon lime soda, the result is 4 liters of punch, and therefore the ratio of soda to punch is 1 to 4. This is the ratio of soda to the total amount of punch. Next, what percent of the punch is soda? Well, because the ratio of soda to punch is 1 to 4, and the 4 represents the total amount of the mixture, we can also say 1/4 of the punch is soda. So beginning with the fraction of 1/4, or ratio of 1 to 4, if we rewrite this as a fraction where the denominator is 100, we can determine the percent of punch that is soda because a percent is a number compared to 100. So because 4 times 25 is equal to 100, and 1 times 25 is equal to 25, we now know 25% of the punch is soda. For part D, we're asked how many liters of juice will Amy need if she plans to use 6 liters of soda. Well, we know the ratio of soda to juice is 1 to 3. So beginning with the ratio of soda to juice, which is 1 to 3, we can write a proportion to determine how many liters of juice Amy will need if she uses 6 liters of soda. A proportion is formed when we set two rates or ratios equal to each other. So for our second ratio, we must compare the number of liters of soda to the number of liters of juice. And we're given Amy wants to use 6 liters of soda, so the second ratio is 6 liters of soda to an unknown number of liters of juice. We can create equivalent ratios just like we create equivalent fractions. So because 1 times 6 is equal to 6 and 3 times 6 equals 18, we now know if Amy uses 6 liters of soda, Amy will need 18 liters of juice. For part E, how many liters of soda will Amy need if she needs to make 40 liters of punch? We said earlier, if Amy uses 1 liter of soda and 3 liters of juice, the result is 1 plus 3, which equals 4 liters of punch. And therefore, we know that the ratio of soda to punch is 1 to 4. Forming a proportion, we'd have the ratio of 1 to 4 must equal, again, the ratio of soda to punch, and Amy wants 40 liters of punch, and therefore the second ratio is an unknown number of liters of soda to 40 liters of punch. Writing an equivalent ratio, because 4 times 10 is equal to 40, and 1 times 10 is equal to 10, if Amy wants 40 liters of punch, she will need 10 liters of soda. I hope you found this helpful.